Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Jenny. I'm from Jenny Card Designs. Thanks so much for stopping by to spend some time with me here today. My YouTube channel contains content that is intended to share paper crafting tutorials and inspiration with all of you. I hope that you enjoy. In today's video, I want to talk about what I do in my crafty space to spark creativity. There are some days where I just don't have any ideas, I have no desire to create anything, or I don't feel inspired. So what I do is I come on into my craft room, I sit down, and I start cutting paper. I think by cutting stuff up and prepping card bases and such, it gives me ideas and a chance to spark my own creativity. So for today's video, we're going to go through a few different styles of card sizes and envelopes, and I'll show you how to cut card bases. And I hope this inspires you to get crafty in your space. So let's check out the first project. These are A2 size card bases and envelopes as well. As a card maker, the most important tool in my arsenal of crafts is cardstock and envelopes. Here I have a bunch of heavyweight cardstock and some matching envelopes. These are both jennycarddesigns blue raspberry cardstock and envelopes. The cardstock measures 8.5 inches by 11 inches, and the envelopes measure 4 3/8 by 5 3/4. Now I'm going to bring in my trimmer. I'm going to start cutting this cardstock down to create some A2 size card bases. There are two ways that we can cut these card bases. The first way is by creating a top folding note card by putting your paper in your trimmer across the 8.5 inch side and slicing at 4 1/4 inches. The second way is to put your paper in across the 11 inch side and slice at 5 1/2 inches. So this is going to give us two different sizes of cardstock. One is going to measure 8.5 inches by 5.5 inches. And the other is going to measure 4 1/4 by 11. When we score these, the cards will be the exact same size, just with a different orientation. So I have a score tool, and I also have a Teflon bone folder, and I use each of these for two different purposes. I use my score tool to score on my scoreboard, and the Teflon bone folder to crease the folds. I'm going to pop the 4 1/4 by 11 1/2 inch sheet into my scoreboard, and I'm going to score at 5 1/2 inches. And then for the other piece, the 8.5 by 5.5, I'm going to score at 4 1/4 across the 8.5 inch side. Okay, I'm done with my scoreboard, and now I'm going to crease the folds of my cardstock. I like to fold away from my score mark, and then I use my Teflon bone folder to crease those folds. I like using the Teflon bone folder because it doesn't leave any markings or anything on the cardstock, whereas a cheap plastic scoring tool or other things might mar up the cardstock and leave like a sheen or something across when you're scoring the fold. So I use my Teflon bone folder for that. So I've gone ahead and I've cut up 4 top folding card bases and 4 side folding card bases. So whichever way you decide to cut up your cardstock, you're not limited to a specific orientation. You can turn both of these cards either portrait or landscape. They both work any way that you want them to. And the final measurement of both cards is 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. This is a standard US A2 size card base. So what I'm going to do is take 4 envelopes and 4 cards, and I'm going to put them together in some little sleeves. So I have these Avery L stamp and die storage pockets. I have a ton of them, and I like to put little projects inside of them. So here I'm going to create a note card set at some point. I just haven't decided when, but I've got 4 cards and 4 envelopes ready and prepped to go. So I'll slip these into these little sleeves and put them in my basket that I can set on my desk and come back to later. Okay, so here we go. We've got 2 little packages of cards and envelopes. Let's move along to A7 or 5x7 card bases and envelopes. Okay, let's talk about 5x7 card bases. We're going to start with a piece of cardstock that measures 8.5 inches by 11. And the envelope for this measures 5 1/4 by 7 1/4 inches. Now this card base sometimes is controversial because people find that it can be wasteful to create a card base because you only get one out of a sheet of cardstock. Now let me show you. Across the 11 inch side, we're going to cut this piece of cardstock down to 10 inches. Then we're going to rotate it and we're going to cut it down to 7 inches. So you're left with a couple of scraps. And I like to use those scraps for stamping sentiments, using them to create dimension and pop-up elements in my cards. So I don't find that I waste this very often, but some people don't like to waste and they prefer to get two cards, and that's why that A2 size is more popular within card making. So once I have my card base cut, I'm going to pop it in my scoreboard, and across the 10 inch side, I'm going to score at 5 inches. Again, I'll grab my Teflon bone folder, I'll crease my fold as I fold away from my score mark, and I'll give it a good press, make sure I have good sharp creases. I'm using a really heavyweight cardstock here. This is Accent Opaque Digital cardstock. It's really nice for heavy card bases. So I'm going to put a couple of packages of these in my little basket. I've got 2 packages of 4 envelopes and 4 card bases. So now I've got a little project bin started here where I've got my A2 and A7 card bases. So whenever creativity strikes, I'm all ready to go. As weird as it may seem, this to me is very satisfying by having things inside of this little basket to start to work on. In case you're interested, this is an InterDesign container. I use these containers for a lot of my craft room storage. So let's check out some more card bases. Let's take a look at slimline envelopes and card bases. There are quite a few variations of slimline card bases and envelopes. For today, I'm going to use these jennycarddesigns envelopes. I have these in my stash. I've had them for a little bit. And I'd like to use some of these envelopes up to try to create something a little different than my normal card. I typically like to create slimline card bases that measure 8 1/2 by 3 1/2. I like that size better, but for the purposes of today's video, to fit these cards into this envelope, I'm going to cut the 9 by 4 inch size card base. These slimline envelopes measure 4 1/4 by 9 1/2 inches. And I'm going to be using a regular standard 8 1/2 by 11 inch piece of cardstock. So let's pull in the trimmer and get these cut down. So I'm going to cut across the 8 1/2 inch side. I'm going to cut this down to 8 inches. And then I'm going to rotate the cardstock and cut to 9 inches. And same as I mentioned before, you can use those scraps for sentiments and tags and so many different things that you can use these for. These are not waste. I always find ways to use these little strips and things, so I like to keep those off to the side and pull them out whenever I need them. Okay, I'm going to pop this card base into my scoreboard, and across the 8-inch side, I'm going to score at 4 inches. And then I'll crease my fold with my Teflon bone folder, and this fits perfectly inside of these envelopes. My finished card base measures 9 by 4, so I'm going to slip these cards inside of the envelope and I'll store them in my little crafty bucket with the rest of my cards and envelopes that I've cut up already. So let's take a look at huge cards and envelopes. Now this is a tutorial that I had just made in my previous video on creating these gorgeous 5 3/4 by 9 inch envelopes using 12 by 12 inch pattern paper. I'll link to that video in the top right hand corner, as well as in the description box down below. So for this card base, there are no fancy cutting measurements. We're going to take a regular standard 8 1/2 by 11 inch sheet of cardstock and score it in our scoreboard across the 11 inch side, and we're going to score at 5 1/2 inches. This is going to give us a perfect size card base to fit inside of these big envelopes. I'm going to fold my card bases, same as I had multiple times in this video, and I'm going to slip them inside of these envelopes and store them in my little bucket. Now, I'm a fan of huge cards. I love huge cards. I love the ability to decorate and create all sorts of fun things, and creating those big cards really packs a punch. All right, so here's a look at my Enter Design container with all of my note card sets and card bases that I've made in today's video. I have a ton of projects for when I feel inspired. When creativity sparks, I'll be ready to create some gorgeous card projects. Okay, so that's it for today's video. Thank you so much for taking time out of your day to spend it here with me. I hope that this video has been informative and inspires you to get to chopping up the cardstock in your craft room. So coming up on screen are a couple of videos I think you may enjoy, including the full playlist for my Chop It Up series. Have yourself a lovely day, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!